all the files of the German intelligence service on the Soviet army. It must have been the best information on the Soviet army outside the Soviet Union itself.
Hans Hinrichs vratio se u Elensalm kad je poklekla sovjetska vlast i kad su se ujedinile zapadna i istočna Njemačka. 45 godina prije toga, on i kolege točno su zaključili da će Sjedinjene Američke Države poduzeti sve kako bi zapadnu Europu zaštitile pred komunističkim napadom. Iskopane njemačke tajne postaće okosnica američkim obavještajnim akcijama.
We wanted to save them for the American forces, because everybody in the high command, being very strongly anti-communist, felt that the Americans would be the only force to keep the Soviet army from overrunning Germany.
Crvena je armija, potkraj rata, zauzela velike dijelove Europe. SAD su se bojale da Stalin ne osvoji ostatak kontinenta. U Washingtonu je hladnoratovsko sumnjičenje zamijenilo suradnju koja ih je tijekom rata vezala u Sovjete. Trebalo je uspostaviti službu za obranu od iznenadnih napada, za usklađivanje obavještajne službe i tajnih operacija. Predsjednik Truman je u srpnju 1947. osnovao Centralnu obavještajnu službu, CIA. Njemačka je već bila tajno bojno polje. U Njemačku je upućen mladi časnik CIA James Critchfield da utvrdi bi li CIA preuzela Hitlerova obavještajce generala Reinharda Gehlena, osposobljene u borbi protiv Crvene armije.
The reason that I recommended in my original report in December 1948, that we accept responsibility for this organization was that we really had no choice. We had no specialists who had dealt with Soviet forces. So here we had the only instrument at hand that could immediately do this.
Znanje generala Reinharda Gehlena i njegovih obavještajaca postalo je vrlo važno u hladnoratovskim okršajima CIA. Uskoro je vođa Hitlerovih obavještajaca došao sa Jamesom Critchfieldom na dogovor u Washington.
Gehlen's people had real capability to produce intelligence on East Germany and on the readiness of the Soviet Air Force to support a ground attack. All of this was real life and death intelligence during this period. And I think it's for that reason that there was no questioning by anyone of the value of it at that moment in history.
Berlin 50-ih postaje špijunska prijestolnica svijeta. Nije bilo zida, samo se u Berlinu mogao proći željezni zastor. Svakog se trenutka očekivao rat. Časnici CIA zauzeli su položaje na prvoj crti obrane. Tom Polgar djelovao je u Njemačkoj od 1947. do 1961. Prvo mu je namještenje bilo u berlinskoj bazi CIA.
Berlin base evolved into one of the most important CIA installations anywhere in the world. It was the only place where you are up against the Russians belly to belly, so to speak. It was the only place where American officers could routinely and on a daily and continuing basis deal with Soviets, observe Soviets, and for that matter have the Soviets observe us. But also the operational climate developed where certain things were possible here that would not have been possible, say, in London or Paris or Rome. There was a set of mind here to shoot the cannon if you were aiming at the butterfly. So, our colleagues felt that Berlin consisted of a bunch of cowboys, that we were a little bit too wild.
Zapadna je Njemačka poslije 1945. bila puna Rusa antikomunista. CIA se odmah njima poslužila da ometa Staljinovo carstvo. Mirovni aktivist William Sloan Coffin, svećenik, uvježbavao je u Minhenu ruske bjegunce za račun CIA od 1950. do 1953.
Well, it did seem to be doing the work of the Lord to try to help patriotic, courageous young Russians overthrow a cruel, terrible dictator. If I'd been a Russian at that age, I would have been one of them. So it wasn't hard for me to believe in a resistance movement that would overthrow a person who had killed so many millions of Russians, in the same way that some very dedicated German Christians, including the great theologian Bonhoeffer, plotted against the life of Hitler.
Mihail Kudryavtsev izvrsno se sjeća svog učitelja Coffina.
И ко мне лично тоже очень хорошо относился. Я с ним никогда стычек у меня не было никаких. Вот. И он... Вообще он очень был привлекательный человек. Во-первых, он умел, хорошо говорил по-русски, умел петь песни русские, танцевать. А это как-то, знаете, для молодых импонировало.
CIA je iza željeznog zastora vodila slične operacije kao za vrijeme rata. Svojim je padobrancima Rusima CIA izmislila identitet. CIA je dobila zadatak. Na svakom strateški važnom aerodromu između Berlina i Urala mora imati svog agenta radista. Agenta je zrakoplovom izbacivala na cilj.
By the dawn's early light, you go out to watch. You just can't stay inside any longer. And then I can't tell you what a moment it is when that speck does reappear, gets larger and larger. Finally, you pick up the roar of the engine. The plane comes over the field like this, showing off madly, and then comes back, comes in on the runway, and you can see the holes in the fuselage. Because when they go over the border, border guards open up on them. The planes have to fly very low to avoid radar, and they have to dodge this way and that to change their pattern. It's a very delicate, dicey, dangerous operation to be a pilot on something like this. Very courageous men did the flying. And then the jump master takes off the door, and before the plane even stops, he jumps off and says, well, that was some night it was, you know, and he starts counting the holes in the fuselage. It's an incredible moment. But then you can't wait to hear if the first signal was sent.
Agenti su se trebali javiti radijom čim bi stigli.
Получилось это очень просто. Когда нас ночью выбросили с парашюта, с самолета, очень самолет удачно зашел, все хорошо. Но место, видно, ошибка летчика была, то ли он не учел ветер, был сильный дождь. И нас выбросили в лес. Хотя у меня и была веревка и все, но лес был такой высокий. Мне это не помогло, даже веревка. Мне не хватило веревки. Я когда с дерева, я не, груз не сумел отцепить. И я не достиг земли. Я, наверное, выпрыгнул с метров шести с дерева и повредил себе ногу. До сих пор я хромаю.
Чекало га нечто много горе. У шуми су га дочекале советские снаги сигурности.
6 февраля 1957 года в Москве состоялась пресс-конференция. На ней выступили задержанные органами государственной безопасности американские шпионы и диверсанты. Рассказывает Кудрявцев.
Я один из тех молодых перемещенных советских граждан, которых американская разведка толкнула на путь шпионажа и диверсий против Советского Союза.
Михаил Кудрявцев осужден на 30 лет затвора. Философски гледа на прошлост.
Вот, говорили, что вас могут и арестовать, вас могут и пытать, и все, поэтому вам даем ампулу. Если вы не выдержите, примите яд или еще что-то. Говорили. Вот. Даже учили, как себя вести в тюрьме. Что все это учили. Как со следователем общаться. Что могут быть пытки и все это. Все, все предупреждали. Не они виноваты. Сами мы добровольно пошли, как говорится. И... Так что тут при чем тут ЦРУ? Конечно, жалко, что так получилось.
Русская эмигрантская скупина НТС вербовала е Кудрявцева и многие другие младе русе за падобранские акции. Njihove slike još vise u počasnoj dvorani Frankfurtske službe.
I would have to say that every operation with which I was connected was a total failure because they were captured and while some appeared later on television, we also know that some were lost, some were executed. I think everybody in that I've known in the CIA believes it was because we were, as they say in the trade, penetrated. At some point, somebody found out where the drop zone was. Somebody knew the night in which the men were going to be flown in. And who that person was, whether it was one of our own trainees or whether it was somebody at headquarters Germany or somebody back in Washington, or even there's a chance that Mr. Philby, who was in on a lot of these operations when he was in Washington at that time, might have known himself. I just don't know, and I don't know that anybody knows.
Možda bi to mogao znati Nikolaj Hohlov, kapetan sovjetske obavještajne službe i osposobljeni ubojica. Hohlov je u ožujku 1954. poslan u Frankfurt da ubije Georgija Oklovića, koji je vrbovao mlade Ruse za skupinu NTS.
I was sitting one day in that small hotel and looking through that window there, and somewhere in Frankfurt was Oklović. And suddenly, I had a feeling that not only I have to visit him sooner or later, but I have to do it now. And so there I was in front of the house, looking at the window that was lit. And I pressed the door, kind of telling myself, the door, of course, is locked, and I wouldn't be crazy to ring it. And I pressed the door, hoping it will be closed, but it wasn't. It opened like that, and then it was too late. I was already going in, like, you know, with a push over wind. I went in, went up the stairs, and then I rang the bell, and I knew that was that. So, whatever it was, it was, to some extent, was eerie. The door opens, and Okolovich was there, looking at me, asking directly, without words, who I am, and I said, Georgi Sergeyevich, I came to you from Moscow, and the Central Committee of the Communist Party made a decision that you should be killed. I am a leader of that team, and the assassins, they are very well equipped with the weapons, and the operation has been prepared very well. And then I tried to put all things together, and I said, but I cannot do it. I cannot allow that to happen.
Hohlov nije isplanirao što će se dogoditi. Ugovorio je sastanak s Oklovićem nekoliko dana poslije u automobilu ispred Frankfurtske opere.
Well, there I was in the car. Okolovich was sitting here, and at the moment I sat down, he turns to me, and with some apprehension in his voice, he tells me, Nikolai Evgenievich, you know, the Americans decided to come also. Do you have anything against that? And before I could say I had everything against that, I turned to the right, and there was the belt buckle. Right in front of me here, there was an American already standing there. So I realized that we probably are surrounded. There was no point of trying to get away. There was no chance anyway, so I got out. He made me go in the back seat, sat here, and we took off.
Suhohlofa da pomogne cilj ostvariti jedan od najrazvikanijih propagandnih štosova hladnog rata.
Kidnapped him. He was clearly on an illegal errand, you know, and had we told the German police, he certainly would have been arrested. I think we saved him from a little embarrassment by putting him up in a nice safe house in the Taunus Mountains, you know, where he was certainly kept under humane conditions. And I suppose during the period when we were trying to establish his bona fides, his freedom of movement was limited, but that was as much for his own security.
A cloak and dagger mystery unfolds in West Germany as Captain Nikolai Kokhlov, former MVD agent, tells a press conference of his murder mission for the Kremlin.
Я 13 лет служил в одном из самых секретнейших отделов советской разведки.
An American weapons expert examines the lethal weapons provided for the assassination. Cigarette cases containing electrical firing devices propel a cyanide-coated bullet into the victim as a fake cigarette is offered. Kokhlov tells the conference that he was dissuaded by his wife and asks the free world's help in saving her from red vengeance. It is a startling ending to a chapter in the never-ceasing struggle across the Iron Curtain as would-be assassin and near victim shake hands in the safety of political asylum.
CIA je u prvom redu morala prikupiti podatke. Sovjetski je štab u istočnom Berlinu postao ciljem najčuvenije tajne operacije CIA, operacije Zlato. CIA je otkrila da Sovjeti šalju šifrirane poruke u Moskvu telefonskim linijama uz granicu sa zapadnim Berlinom. Odlučili su da će ih prisluškivati. Uz granicu su podigli radarsku postaju i prokopali tunel do telefonskih vodova. policija je brzo skupila podatke o sovjetskim snagama u istočnoj Njemačkoj. Ni najčuvanije tajne nisu više bile tajne.
Die Sowjetunion hat dort solche Chiffriergeräte eingesetzt und offensichtlich an die Sicherheit ihrer eigenen Chiffriermittel geglaubt. Heute wissen wir, dass sie nicht so sicher waren. Naja, da ist aber die Sowjetunion nicht der Erste und nicht der Einzige, der diesem Irrtum verfallen ist.
Nekoliko mjeseci poslije prisluškivanja telefonskih razgovora, projektant tunela, Jerry Fallon, pozvan je da riješi problem. Izazvali su ga partneri CIA u operaciji Zlato, Britanci. Komora s opremom našla se ispod ulice u istočnom Berlinu.
This was a joint operation with the British. It was their equipment, GPO, amplifiers and so forth. They provided the data for the heat generation of this equipment, and for some reason or another, it was wrong, almost by a factor of 100%. We began to notice that the temperature was rising, and the equipment got really hot in the equipment room. Our worry was is that some frosty morning we would have this frost-free black line 6 feet wide. Pointing toward the side of the road and pointing back toward the radar station.
Fallon je riješio problem i uveo sistem hlađenja. U siječnju 1956. istočni su Njemci, prema naredbi KGB-a, pregledali to područje.
Es wurde im Winter mit Metallsuchgeräten dieses Feld abgesucht. Es wurde ein wenig die Legende verbreitet, dort werden Blindgänger aus dem Zweiten Weltkrieg gesucht. War eigentlich auch nichts Besonderes. In Berlin werden heute noch Blindgänger gefunden, sodass das also überhaupt keinen Verdacht erregt hat. Und es wurde tatsächlich mit diesen Geräten eine solche Linie, Metalllinie zwischen dem Objekt US-Radarstation und der Straße gefunden.
Komunisti su poslije 3 mjeseca otkrili javnosti taj tunel. A odmah s onu stranu granice bila je američka radarska postaja.
Ich war mit bei den ersten, die da drin waren, dass man den Amerikanern eine solche Frechheit, könnte man sagen, eine, man kann auch Kühnheit sagen, also gar nicht zugetraut hat.
Svi su se divili američkoj snalažljivosti. Tunel je postao propagandni trijumf CIA. Da stvar bude ljepša, britanski je izdajica George Blake od samog početka o svemu obavještavao KGB.
Assuming that it was compromised from the beginning by Blake, I have no trouble reconciling the operation of the activity with the Soviet knowledge that it is going on. The Soviets knew perfectly well what traffic passes on that channel or on those channels. They also knew that since they knew that there was not going to be a war, that is, they are not going to attack anybody, all this military intelligence is interesting, but basically without value. Because it's going to be overtaken by time anyway. On the other hand, Blake is such a valuable asset that you want to do everything possible to protect him.
Wir haben uns dann meistens in West-Berlin getroffen. Da gab es so ein kleines Stundenkino. Und dann bin ich in das Kino hineingegangen. Und er ist auch hineingegangen. Und dann haben wir uns nebeneinander gesetzt. Und ich habe ihm meine Informationen übergeben. Und er ist dann schnell hinausgegangen, hat sie dann an einen anderen weitergegeben. Und ich bin dann gefolgt. Und da sind wir ein bisschen spazieren gegangen. Abends im Halbdunkel, im Dunkel, so am Tiergarten entlang.
bivšem SS-ovcu Heinzu Felfeu izvrsno su bili poznati pojmovi povjerenja i izdaje. Felfe je djelovao u sklopu Gelenove skupine koja je radila za CIA. Divili su mu se najugledniji kolege iz CIA.
Competent ability. There are various kinds of intelligence officers, you know. There are the analyst of substance, there are those who sort of in the mode of Jean Le Carré are the ultimate secret service officer. He was of the Jean Le Carré variety. He was an intelligence officer, if I can say that.
In Bonn wurden das ehemalige Hotel Rolandseck und die Villa Hensen für die sowjetische Botschaft vorbereitet.
Gelenovi ljudi su za račun CIA prisluškivali novu sovjetsku ambasadu u Bonnu. Prije nego što je veleposlanik stigao u obnovljenu zgradu, Heinz Felfe postavio je u nju prislušne uređaje.
Die Verantwortung für die Operationen gegen die sowjetischen Missionen, also Botschaft und Handelsvertretung, lag absolut und allein in meinen Händen. Ich war zuständig fürs Telefonabhören, ich war zuständig für den Einbau von Mikrofonen, ich war zuständig für die Auswertung der aufgezeichneten Telefongespräche und Auswertung der Fernschreiben. Die Ergebnisse gingen dann natürlich an CIA.
Resultate je dobivao i KGB. Felfe radio i za Ruse. Odmah posle rata počeo je s njima surađivati. Oni su ga poslali da stupi u Gelenovu službu. Bio je najopasniji KGB-ovac u Njemačkoj.
Das öffnete natürlich auch dem KGB die Möglichkeiten, Informationen auszugeben, die die andere Seite irreführte, um sie zu täuschen. Das gehört zum Gewerbe der Geheimdienste, nicht nur aufzuklären, sondern auch die andere Seite zu täuschen, irre zu führen. Und insofern war das alles für die Sowjets natürlich sehr, sehr nützlich.
Felfe je 50. godina djelovao u Gelenovu središtu kod Minhena. Nadasve je postao opasan kad je došao na položaj na kojemu je morao suzbijati infiltriranje KGB-a u zapadnu Njemačku.
Felfe was in an absolutely key spot to tip off the Soviets of activities directed against Soviet operations in West Germany. Because those operations would usually be handled in the counterintelligence channel. And in that sense, Felfe was as damaging to our counterintelligence operations in Germany as, say, our operations were affected by Kim Philby's role in the late 40s or early 50s.
Heinz Felfe uhičen je 1961. I osuđen na 14 godina zatvora. Poslije je razmijenjen u špijunskoj razmjeni.
My name is Ronald Reagan. Last year, the contributions of 16 million Americans to the Crusade for Freedom made possible the World Freedom Bell, symbol of hope and freedom to the communist-dominated peoples of Eastern Europe, and built this powerful 135,000-watt radio-free Europe transmitter in Western Germany. This station daily pierces the Iron Curtain with the truth, answering the lies of the Kremlin and bringing a message of hope to millions trapped behind the Iron Curtain. Grateful letters from listeners smuggled past the secret police express thanks to Radio Free Europe for identifying communist quislings and informers by name. The Crusade for Freedom is your chance and mine to fight communism. Join now by sending your contributions to General Clay, Crusade for Freedom, Empire State Building, New York City. Or join in your local community.
A pontos idő 13 óra.
Ronald Reagan nije rekao da CIA financira radio Slobodnu Europu. Neki su dužnosnici CIA mislili da radio Slobodna Europa, kao još neke postaje koje financira SAD, može pomoći u oslobađanju Istočne Europe.
Russian troops pour into embattled East Berlin to smash anti-Red strike riots, which had virtually paralyzed the sector. Scenes like these, filmed with long-lens cameras from the American zone, were repeated in other cities of Soviet-occupied Germany. And the Reds brought it all on themselves, despite their wild claims of saboteurs incited by the West.
The uprising on 17 June gave many of our more enthusiastic Cold Warriors the idea that sort of their theory has been vindicated, that the Soviet system in occupied Europe is falling apart, and now a start has been made in East Germany, and if we get in actively, the thing is going to spread.
Takozvana teorija oslobađanja imala je najviše izglede 1956. Kad su Mađari ustali protiv komunista u Budimpešti. Radio Slobodna Europa umnogome je ohrabrivao Mađare. Deseci mjesnih radiopostaja koje su se pojavile u oslobođenim područjima Mađarske često su izvještavali o mogućoj američkoj pomoći. Radio Slobodna Europa prenosio je njihove emisije bez komentara. CIA je vodila te izvještaje.
Oh, they were extraordinarily dramatic. Town would announce that it had overthrown the Communist Party, that the Hungarian secret police was being taken care of, and that all other towns in Hungary should follow the same example. In other words, they were one after another moving into a position of rejection of the whole communist system.
Emisije radija Slobodna Europa poticale su oružani ustanak. Mađari su iz toga shvatili da će im Amerikanci pomoći.
Hogyan hangzott első szavunk, és azóta minden szavunk győzedelmes forradalomhoz, ne add ki fegyveredet kezedből, nép, mert ez a fegyver azonos volt a győzelemmel, mert akié a fegyver, azé a hatalom.
This is the death of liberty in Budapest. Encircled by units from 15 Red Armored Divisions that have poured into Hungary, patriots fight to the last ditch.
I kad je otpor postao bezizgledan, Radio Slobodna Europa poticao je Mađare da se nastave boriti.
One of the broadcasts was a message addressed directly to me. And the message was that unquestionable, I was the top officer of the Hungarian resistance, that my patriotic duty was to fight the Russians to the last. He did not mention any promise that the American Marines will come or something, but his message was so forceful that I became very, very much confused for hours, because our opinion was that Radio Free Europe was a voice of the American government. Consequently, if that voice encourages me to resist, there must be a government decision or plan behind it.
Nije bilo nikakva plana. Amerikanci nisu ponudili pomoć. General Bela Kiralj i njegovi ljudi pobjegli su na zapad. General poslije 35 godina u Mađarskoj kojom više ne vladaju komunisti predsjedava komemoraciji revolucije.
Judging the mentality of younger freedom fighters with whom of course I was in daily contact after the left the country, there was a tremendous disappointment among them that we were not helped, that the West let us down, etc. Many of them believed that they were betrayed.
After the events of the Hungarian intervention by the Soviet Union, we reviewed all the scripts and found a number of them where there was clearly more enthusiasm, more willingness to talk as if liberation was imminent than really the situation justified.
Mađarska je revolucija pokazala da Sjedinjene Države neće u rat da se makne željezni zastor. Bila je to prekretnica za CIA.
I was chief of the Eastern European operation at the time. I think that that the Hungarian Revolution very clearly spelled the end to any serious discussion of rollback. But I think at that point it became apparent that you had a confrontation between these two great alliances, with enormous number of troops, very well-defined front line, and that the era of experimentation had ended.
Poslije Mađarske revolucije, Nikita Hruščov sve se više zabrinjavao zbog tisuća istočnih Njemaca koji su preko Berlina bježali na zapad.
We all knew something was going to happen. The border was too loose. There was a population drainage, a hemorrhage from East Germany coming into the West. All of a sudden, this hemorrhage assumed arterial proportions. Something of a panic had set in. There were 2,000 refugees on a Monday, 4,000 on Tuesday, 6,000 on Wednesday. Ulbricht, the head of East Germany, went to Moscow, got permission to lower the boom. I'm not using the word wall, came back and lowered the boom. We knew the boom was about to fall. We didn't realize it was going to take the form of a physical wall surrounding West Berlin, but that is the form it took.
East German troops swooped down on the border between Red Berlin and the Free City in the pre-dawn hours to close the 66 points where movement between the sectors has been relatively free. East Berliners who held coveted jobs in the West were told to stay home, and the elevated trains were halted. Mayor Willy Brandt, commenting on this latest Russian move in the War of Nerves, cautioned East Berliners against revolt. The Russians have told their people that the border was closed to prevent the infiltration of agents from the West. Never a word about those who fled to the arms of freedom, fled from the rule of guns and tanks, and cast ominous shadows on the red side of freedom's border.
Clearly, the government as a whole was not alerted to the possibility that something drastic is going to happen in Berlin, which requires an immediate American counteraction, one way or another, whether physical or just oral or political. So in that sense, it was certainly an intelligence failure. But I think we have to be careful of where we want to pinpoint the blame.
Za Berlinski zid građevinarci su se morali tjednima spremati, a berlinska služba u kojoj je u to vrijeme radilo 70-ak obavještajaca s punim radnim vremenom pojma nije imala.
You would have had to have had one of the top three men in the East German government to get even 24 hours warning that a wall was going up. You talk of logistical. We had requirements to get agents in practically every sector of the Eastern Bloc. To tell that the logistic arrangements were being made would have involved recruiting several people in masonry supply and truck services. They probably weren't on the list.
Na ovom je polju smrti u 28 godina ubijena 191 osoba koja je pokušavala prebjeći na zapad. Don Morris priča nam kako se tada promijenio rad berlinske baze.
Our problem now was that we had a magnificent array of agents scattered throughout East Berlin and East Germany with whom we couldn't get in touch. And we had to put on alternative communications the hard way. What we call tradecraft, the basic nuts and bolts of espionage, had to be brought into play. We had secret writing systems. Some of us, at least with some of our agents, had secret writing SW on the back of mail. The mails weren't stopped. Some of them were looked at, but most of them weren't caught. We could write our people. They could write to us. Others we had to send couriers in, or we had to put dead drops down in the east and then notify the agents, come and pick it up. One way or another, bit by bit, the alternative Kamo was built back up.
Profesor Adolf Henning Frucht potječe iz ugledne njemačke obitelji intelektualaca. Poslije rata 1945. odlučio je ostati u istočnoj Njemačkoj. Vodio je zavod za medicinu rada u istočnom Berlinu i omogućio je istočno-njemačkim veslačima da dobiju olimpijsko zlato. Istočno-njemačka ga je vojska pitala koliko je plinska maska učinkovita u kemijskom ratu. Godine 1962. osobito je dobro upoznao jednog istočno-njemačkog generala.
Und eines Tages kam der General zu mir und sagte, wir haben ein neues Verfahren, um Gasmasken für große Kälte sicher zu machen. Und ich sagte, wozu das? Denn chemische Waffen kann man sowieso nicht bei Kälte einsetzen. Und er sagte, oh doch, das kann vorkommen. Wir haben sogar eine ganz spezielle Aufgabe dafür. Die Amerikaner haben in Alaska Radarbasen zum Schutz des Festlandes. Und dort ist es immer sehr kalt im Winter und man könnte dort Kampfstoffe verwenden, um die Radarbasen auszuschalten. Und da sagte ich, wie, was wollen Sie? Ja, sagte er, wenn die plötzlich ausfallen, dann würden die Amerikaner schlecht dran sein. Und unsere Freunde, das war ein Ausdruck für die Russen, haben gesagt, wenn wir nur wenige Stunden die Vereinigten Staaten schutzlos machen könnten mit solchen einem Angriff von chemischen Waffen auf die Radarbasen, so würde das für die Verhältnisse sehr günstig sein.
Istočni Njemci nisu znali da je Frucht američki agent. Morao je podatak javiti CIA u zapadni Berlin, ali zbog zida nije mogao sam. Za Tekliča je izabrao svog nećaka.
When I was asked to establish contact between Americans and my uncle, I found it very natural because having lived in Eastern Germany in the 50s, I was brought up with the idea that communism was just the devil and anything American was heaven.
Zapadni Berlinci nisu smjeli dolaziti u istočni Berlin, ali zapadni Njemci smjeli su preko zida. Malte Heikster stanovao je u zapadnoj Njemačkoj.
I thought it would be nice to work in this sort of field, you know, all the James Bond films were going on then, and I thought, well, why not having this adventure?
Heikstera bi uhitili i zatvorili da su ga uhvatili kako prenosi znanstvene ili tehničke tajne iz istočne Njemačke. Studirao je glazbu. Nije bio znanstveno potkovan, pa se trebalo snaći kako zapamtiti podatke.
Sicher, wie ich einmal mit dieser Musik ankam.
Ja.
Das, ich nahm gerade Mozart, vierte G-Moll-Symphonie, vierter Satz durch im Studium. Und wir waren ja da auf die Idee gekommen, dass die ganzen schwierigen Wörter, die ich manchmal nicht merken konnte, durch Musik ganz gut umschrieben werden konnten. Wir haben einfach die Tonleiter durchnummeriert. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Und bei den Buchstaben A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A und so weiter. Und auf diese Weise konnten wir ganz komplizierte Worte für mich erinnerbar machen.
Ich erinnere mich, da war noch dieses Saxitoxin.
Saxitoxin,
was du nicht merken konntest. Kannst du das mal spielen?
Saxitoxin, ja. S, A, X, I, T, O, X, E, N. Also eine schöne Musik eigentlich, nicht?
Army and Air Force tactical air units exercise in the hostile environment of the Alaskan interior. physical control of the air components of the exercise known as Polar Siege is effected from the Tactical Air Control Center.
So kam es, dass der General eines Tages zu mir gesagt hat, na sehen Sie mal, die Amerikaner in Alaska haben angefangen, große Sicherungsmaßnahmen für ihre Radarbasen zu machen. Und jetzt erhebt sich die Frage, das war also wörtlich, was er gesagt hat, jetzt erhebt sich die Frage, haben wir eine undichte Stelle in unserem System oder sind die Amerikaner von alleine draufgekommen? Da wusste ich, dass meine Zeit vorbei war.
Frucht je 1968. uhićen. Prijetila mu je smrtna kazna, ali je osuđena doživotnu robiju. Poslije 10 godina robije oslobođen je u špijunskoj razmjeni. CIA mu je dala kovčeg pun novca i zatražila od njega da nikad ne spominje prošlost.
Ich glaube, dass sowohl im Ansatz die CIA eine menschenverachtende Komponente hat, in dem Sinne eben, dass die Leute als Objekte angesehen werden. Ich bedauere, dass die Amerikaner nicht großzügiger mir gegenüber waren in der inneren Haltung, dass sie nicht verstanden haben, dass ich die Erinnerung an die Haft dadurch überwinden muss, dass ich davon spreche.
Berlinska baza CIA bila je vruća točka špijunskog rata. Ali beton kojim je istočna Njemačka zaustavila odljev svojih građana, zaustavio je i dotok podataka. CIA je svoje operacije preselila.
The wall was a monumental event in terms of intelligence operations. It absolutely changed the pattern of operations. It greatly reduced the significance of Berlin base. Most of the East German collection now had to take place from West Germany or from countries as far away as Colombia, where you could maybe get at the German, East German commercial attaché. So East German operations from then on resembled a lot more the traditional pattern of our operations against the Soviets, which meant that you could collect successfully in more successfully in almost any part of the world than you could actually in Moscow. Well, the same thing happened in Berlin.
Zbog sve većih teškoća kojima su se izvrgavali ljudi na zadatku u sovjetskom bloku, CIA se 60. godina sve više usmjeravala na strojno prikupljanje podataka. Počelo je novo razdoblje špijunaže.